In this video, let us study something more about steel plants. The steel plants are of two types. One is integrated steel plants and one is mini steel plant. So in India there are almost 10 integrated steel plants and there are many mini steel plants. Now what is the difference between integrated steel plant and a mini steel plant? Now mini steel plant are small steel plants which uses scrap materials as their raw materials. So and they use electric furnaces for making steel and they also use sponge iron for making steel. They have re-rollers that use steel ingots. Steel ingots means long pieces of steel and they use only they produce only mild and alloy steel of given specification. They don't make all type of steels. But integrated steel plant is a large steel plant. So the difference, one difference is this is small, this is large. Mini steel plant do not handles everything while integrated steel plant handles everything in one complex. That is from putting together raw materials to steel making. Here in integrated plant, raw materials for making steel includes iron ore, then there is coking coal and limestone in the ratio 4:2:1, and they also add manganese to harden the steel, and then they give rolls and rolling and shaping is also done in the integrated steel plant. And the furnace used in the integrated steel plant is the blast furnace, while in mini steel plant it is the electric furnace. So it uses scrap materials and sponge iron as raw material. So in India we have almost 10 integrated steel plants. That is big. Integrated itself means joined together. Many processes are joined together. Now in India there are many steel plants in public sector also and many in private sectors also. So all the public sector undertakings, in all the public sector undertakings, the steel is marketed with the help of Steel Authority of India Limited. While TISCO, Tata Iron Steel Company, which is in private sector, they market their steel themselves. Then during 1950s, India and China were almost equal in producing steel. So they produce almost same quantity of steel. But today China is the largest producer also and consumer also of steel. And in 2004, India became the largest exporter because we are producing more, but we are not using. So we whatever we are producing, we are exporting. So that is why we were the greatest exporter in 2004. And almost 2.25% of global steel trade is done by India. We are not consuming, we are exporting, while China is consuming. In India, Cholanagpur Plateau is the area where raw materials are easily available, iron ore is easily available. So most of the plants are located in the Cholanagpur area. And maximum iron steel industries are located in that area because they have certain advantage of development. Advantage includes close availability or close proximity of the raw material, and cheaply they can get the raw material from there. Industries can get raw material at low cost. High grade of raw materials are present there nearby. Then cheap labor and vast growth of potential in the home markets. That means nearby markets, there are many industries, so it can be easily sold. So these are some of the factors why